Okay, in this video I'd like to talk about creating a custom Malverse projection and reprojecting the shapefiles. We're going to use these two tools, well, this one tool, and this is really what I kind of think of as a parameter. I really hope my voice isn't stressing you out, but this might be the last video I do tonight. The concept here is an Albers equilateral conic projection that we haven't talked about. And I just want to reinforce this kind of contrast between defining a special reference versus changing a special reference, and maybe even the third thing being displaying a special reference. Okay, so let's see what I can do here. So I'm going to open up ArcMap, and I think just to start with, I'm going to insert a new data frame. And I'm going to call this Albers. I just want to visualize this projection first. And I'm going to go into the folder I was using last week that had DSOs and Decatrix into it, and bring those on. I'm just going to quickly make them kind of a red color. And then I'd like to add from ArcGIS online the country data. And I'm not in the mood for Easter colors, so I'm just going to quickly make everything a light gray with a white outline. So I said, just give me a single symbol, make it that, and I can handle that. Okay, so right now this is in WGS, so let's reproject this on the fly into a, I'm going to go from continental North American and the North American Albers equilateral conic. And so we have this kind of fan-shaped world. And if you look at it, what you'll see is you'll get the following numbers. There's going to be a central meridian, which is what we're kind of centered on here, 96 degrees west of Greenwich. And then there's going to be two standard parallels and a latitude of origin. So the way that the Albers work is that the scale factor is preserved at the standard parallel. The area is preserved in the area between these two parallels, and there's only really minimal distortion of the objects, of their shape, between those parallels. But there are some distortion, and you're seeing that here, because we're talking about, I'm just going to move this off-site for a second. Crap. Alright, so just remember 2060, latitude of origin is 40. So if we looked at 20 degrees, we're basically down here in somewhere in Mexico, and the scale factor will be preserved here. But as we move away from that, you'll see that there is a little bit of distortion in terms of the shape, but the area of this circle should be the same as that area. And then as we go up here, this is pretty much 60 dead on, so you'll see how the scale factor is preserved here on this parallel, because all the circles are the same size. And if Tiso had drawn these circles on the 20th parallel rather than the 30th parallel, we'd be able to see that on the 20th parallel they'd also be perfect circles. The idea being that the area of these circles is preserved, the shape is distorted, but on the standard parallels the shape and the area is preserved. And as you move between the two standard parallels, you preserve area, you induce a little distortion in shape, but it's not that much compared to outside of the two standard parallels. Okay, so that's the kind of strategy. So what we'd like to say is, all right, given that we have this area of Peru, and let's add on, we've got our points and our lines, and we're going to have our human populations, and we're also going to have our concessions that I'll just throw on there now. And I'm going to make the concessions. I kind of think this is a fairly safe scheme just to do gray and white. And I'm going to throw on the human population points as well. And I'm going to make these Okay, so if this is our data that we're working with primarily, this shape, what we can see is that if we were going to define two standard parallels, we'd like the standard parallels to be kind of on maybe on either side of this feature, and then we can preserve the area between here, but we'd also minimize the distortion to the shape but of all the features that are in between our two standard parallels. So let's just, and then what's our central meridian? We could use maybe negative 70.5 as our central meridian. So what I'm going to say is I'm going to define a new projection, and it's going to be based on the Albers. And I'd like to define it. I'm going to call this the Albers for kind of Peru, or really for the Madre. How is that for poetry? And so the central meridian is going to be negative 70.5. My first standard parallel I'm going to put as negative 10, and my second one I'm going to give as negative 15. And that's because, negative 10 is up here, negative 15 is down here. And that means that this land in between these two parallels will be, again, the area is going to be preserved and the shape will have only a little bit of distortion. And the latitude of origin is going to be in between those two, so negative 12.5. And if I apply this and say okay, and apply it and say okay. So what I'd like to do is get these features all into this projection. And so right now I'm just displaying the data in this projection. All of these features have a spatial reference system that's defined. They're all in WGS. So the problem we had last week is that we needed to define the spatial reference system of features. And that's right. And that's when I showed you that you would go in here and change the kind of definition by editing this or by changing this. But what we want to now do is change the coordinate values of these features. And ideally, I'd like to just do this once, right? So I'm going to go into System Toolboxes and go under Data Management and go under Projections and Transformations and go under Feature. And rather than using Project, what if we could use Batch Project? And that means that I'm going to select all of the features that I want to project into the same spatial reference system. So I'm going to go into my home directory and I'm going to say I'd like you to project this one. I'd like you to project this one. I'd like you to project this one. We don't really have to care about the GPS points anymore. And these all have the same coordinate system. They're all WGS 84. And I'd like to put them, the outputs here, all in my home directory. And I'd like the output to be this new projected system that I'm using, the kind of Albers for our mother. And we're gonna go to Albers. And do you remember what I did here? The central meridian was negative 70.5. The first standard parallel was negative 10. The second standard parallel was negative 15. And the latitude of origin is between those two, negative 12.5. We're gonna keep the datum the same. Apply. Say OK. Now say OK. And I should be able to leave everything else blank. And what this will do is run through and project each shapefile one after the other. So rather than having to pull out that project tool and fill out that GUI four separate times or three separate times, we could just batch project. And now what we should have is under our home, we have this one, and this one that are all in Albers. Anything with a dash one, meaning it was derived from this one. So I can just go in here and change the name of this. say this is actually Albers. Can't I? It's not letting me. Okay. So if I right-click it and say rename, I can now say that this is Albers. This is Albers. And this is Albers. And did it work? The easiest way to test this is to insert a data frame and then drop these files in. And you should get the data frame to be in our Albers from Madre, right? Because it acquired, it inherited the reference system of these features. We added it into it. And we didn't get any complaints about these files being in a different spatial reference system than this. So that suggests that they're all good. And I'm just going to quickly clean up the symbology like I had it before. Let's make that some kind of a river color. And let's make these little points. I don't know if you guys saw exactly how I did that. I reduced the size. I made it black, and then I edited the symbol and got rid of the outline, which is going to make it even smaller. My voice is really going. Okay, and we're getting there.